several hours until he was finally captured. He has done some time in prison. He got out on parole a few weeks ago. Watson has an extensive criminal history dating back to 1999, including charges of theft, forgery, and escape. We have established a real good relationship. Miller's body was discovered by cleaning crews inside her Lakewood office on Tuesday afternoon, shocking her friends and family.
When I think of Claudia, what I think of is a gentle person, very gentle soul, and kind, good lawyer. She seems like the last person you would expect to hear that was murdered because of the way she lived and how gentle she was. We'll really miss her, so we feel very bad for her.
Lakewood police tell us the next step in the investigation is to send detectives to Idaho to question Watson over the weekend. Live in studio 4 Sanchez, Fox 31, Denver. One last step for the bill that will give illegal immigrants in Colorado a break on college tuition. The asset bill, passed in the state House by a margin of 2-1. Lawmakers have tried to pass this bill for the last 10 years. The bill now heads to Governor Haley Lieber Kessler, expected to be signed into law.
Firestorm of calls for more gun laws. While people testified, the victim's family not be equipped with a 100-round magazine. The open fire killed 12, including my son Alex, and injured 58 others.
Those who treated victims also carry emotional scars.
This was a tremendous number of people in a very short period of time with emotional story for us. A very hard thing to go through for everybody.
Now lawyers for James Holmes suffer a setback. Judge ruled Colorado's insanity defense process does not violate his constitutional right to self-determination or his right to remain silent, making it likely he'll plead not guilty by reason of insanity.
And that will trigger all of the consequences of a not guilty by reason of insanity, including a required evaluation from the state and the state hospital.
The state law requires Holmes to cooperate with that evaluation, opening up his medical records, including treatment for psychiatrist Lynn Fenton, who alerted city police he might be dangerous. Legal aid on the state's record says that raises more questions for Holmes' defense.
Are you not cooperating, and therefore you can't use the insanity defense?
The judge promised to answer that question in the next year. And we learned late today that Holmes was taken to Denver Health Medical Center by an ambulance last November, where he was kept for several days in restraints. His attorneys are asking surveillance tape that be turned over. He's due back in court on Tuesday. Dig up Fox 31.
It's not.